I'm going to keep this review nice and short. Despite being about the two most prominent, important, and iconic figures in Catholicism today, you don't have to be religious to enjoy this movie. In school, I once had a prompt to write a scene with two characters in one location. It was a long while ago, but I believe the goal was to create conflict using only dialogue. We had to create something engaging out of something quite limited. And that's exactly what this film feels like. It's just about two guys having very different ideological viewpoints. They spend the majority of the film talking about, arguing over, and debating those perspectives. It's fucking great. I had a blast watching the High Sparrow argue with an elderly Hannibal Lecter. But in all seriousness, these two actors are phenomenal. There's a reason why both Anthony Hopkins and Jonathan Pryce were nominated for Academy Awards. Even though they're both co-leads, the film basically belongs to Pryce as Jorge Bergoglio, the man who eventually becomes Pope Francis. So, if you didn't know, this film is about the transition in the Catholic Church between Pope Benedict and Pope Francis, which was quite unprecedented since the job of a pope is supposed to be for life, as in, until death. But Benedict is still around today, so this was a pretty uncommon circumstance. And the film chronicles the events leading up to Benedict's retirement and how his successor was chosen. Now, I don't know how accurate this movie actually is, and quite frankly, I don't care. I'm not here for the history lesson. I'm here to watch two guys with two very different worldviews and sets of values argue with one another. And that's exactly what I got. I thought Anthony Hopkins may have been losing his mind after his appearance in Transformers The Last Knight, but he's clearly still got it. I loved seeing him as this conservative old man who wants to do right by his followers, but he's lost his way and he's not exactly sure how to do that anymore. And Jonathan Pryce offers the perfect juxtaposition to that character, playing a slightly younger old man who has more of a liberal point of view based on his past experiences, some of which he's not very proud of. There's clearly a disconnect between the Catholic Church and people in the modern era, and I'm not a very religious person myself, so I'm not really here to talk about why that is, but I thought it was fascinating to watch two people who are in that world discuss that issue. If anything, this film allows us to see these two men as individuals. They may be popes, head of the largest religion in the world, but they are still very much human. So I thought this was a very poignant movie that helps connect the audience with these large figures. And even though it may seem as if the narrative picks a side on whose viewpoint should be seen as correct, I'm not exactly sure if that's the case in the real world, since these two guys still very publicly argue about certain matters. But man, it sure did seem like movie magic to see the Pope and the Pope watch the World Cup together. That's just some real fun stuff. So I would likely give the two popes 3 3/4 out of 5 stars. Thanks for watching.